Hey y'all, welcome to my channel. I'm Melissa, if you haven't been here before. Today what we're going to be doing is a Will I Buy It? This is something that Samantha March actually came up with, and I've seen other creators do different versions of it, but I'm actually going to be doing a Will I Buy It today. We're going to be going through some products and I'm going to tell you whether I'm going to buy it, I have bought it with some items, and or if I'm not going to buy it. So we're just going to go through and I'm going to tell you what I think of some of these items and have some fun talking about makeup. So if that's something that you're interested in, then just keep watching. So the first thing that I want to talk about is the Patrick Star brand One Size, and he has come out with the makeup wipes and the makeup remover, but he's come out with a eyeshadow palette as well as, what does he call these? It's the Visionary Eyeshadow Palette Eye Poppers. He calls them Eye Poppers, and he came out with some eyeliners, liquid eyeliners, and then gel eyeliners. So the palette just looks beautiful. I actually did buy this. I'm waiting on it to come in. It hasn't shipped yet from Sephora. And I bought one of the eye poppers. I wanted to try the eye poppers. I got one that was a little more neutral so I could use it more than just, you know, on a couple of different looks. But I was definitely looking at this olive green one. That one looks beautiful. So I was tempted to buy that one, but I wanted to get something a little more neutral that I could use in more than just a... So yeah, so I've already bought this and I'm waiting on this to come in. The next thing is the Viseart. They have two of their little eyeshadow palettes, the Petite Pros. They have a Midsummer Enchanting and the Midsummer Evening. And they're supposed to be soft, cool mattes and shimmers. Four mattes and three shimmers and a duochrome in one of them. Or no. One of them's called Solstice. It's hard to read what. One of them's Midsummer Enchanting, the Midsummer Evening, Enveloped in a Dream of Love. So it's Midsummer is the purpley one, and Solstice is the more like peachy one. So the Midsummer has mattes and shimmers, and the Solstice one has four mattes, three shimmers, and a duochrome in it. A duochrome does look pretty. Now, my weakness is eyeshadow palettes, so let me scoot over a little bit to make it easier for myself to put in these pictures. But my weakness is eyeshadow palettes. So it's hard for me to say that I don't want these palettes, but I'm not big on the Viseart price. So I probably won't be buying these right now. Maybe if there's a Sephora sale. I think I'm close to being a VIB. So if the VIB sale comes and I can get my, 20 or something percent off, then I might be buying these maybe. We'll see. But they're really, really pretty. The next thing is the Wayne Goss eyeshadow palettes, and he also has seen some eyeliners. The eyeshadow palette again looks beautiful. I love to buy this eyeshadow palette, but again, kind of on the expensive side, so I'll probably be waiting on this. Maybe in the future I might buy it. I don't know. We'll see. Eyeliners, I probably won't get into the eyeliners. I'm not a big eyeliner person. I don't use a whole lot of eyeliner. If I use eyeliner, I use it in my waterline, and even then I don't use it a whole lot. So the eyeliners, no, but the eyeshadow palette, maybe one of these days. The next thing is the L'Oreal Paris Air Volume Mega Mascara. It's let me read about it, because it sounds like it would be fabulous. It sounds like another or better Lash Paradise. So I don't know. Let's see. A new evolution of mega lash volume that inflates and puffs up lashes just like a hot air balloon, yet feels light as air, suitable for all lash types. Air whip to create a lash multiplying effect with high volume charge that is weightless on lashes for all day wear, lasting up to 24 hours. With a double bristle brush, captures, separates, and coats every lash from the root to the tip for thick and full lashes. The pink metallic balloon-shaped packaging protects and seals in the airy formula, smudge and flake resistant. It's going to be $13.96, coming soon to Walmart. So yeah, this is something that I definitely would like to try and see how good. I'm always up for a good mascara. So when it comes, I'll probably be buying it. Next we have the House of Labs Gel Pencil Eyeliners. 20 creamy controlled gel pencil shades and matte metallic and shimmer finishes. Long wearing, waterproof and smudge proof with a quick dry down time, and it's $18 each. They look pretty, but I'd rather pick up the NYX ones that are like $8 a piece. That's saving me $10. So it's going to be a no to the House of Labs gel eyeliners. Next we have the Kylie Cosmetics lip blush kit. I probably won't be buying the Kylie lip blush kits. $26 is a little too steep for me for a, well, I say that, but I was willing to pay 30 something for a lipstick. So, I mean, but I'm just not interested in grabbing anything from Kylie at this point in time. Next is the Colored Rain Juicy Boost Collection. You have a palette, the Juicy Boost eyeshadow palette, available in two different versions. Flat for $52, or book version, which has two layers of palettes for $52. 18 shades, 3 highly intensity reflect dazzlers, and 15 buttery smooth mattes, plus an umbrella and a tumbler. I haven't really been trying to buy a whole lot of colorful palettes lately. I've trying to been sticking to neutrals because I know I use them more because I have a lot of colorful palettes right now. So I think that I'm going to skip on this right now, but I probably maybe later on I might buy it because it does look really pretty, and I've heard a lot of good things about the Colored Rain formula. I actually have one palette, but I haven't used it yet. I got it from Ipsy. I need to try it out because it's a neutral palette, but I got it and I just put it up and I forgot I even had it until the other day I saw it. This is something that I might want to try in the future, but right now I don't think I'm gonna buy that. Next is Morphe Brushes 35C Everyday Chic Artistry Palette for $25. Its neutral shades of taupe and camel are complemented by soft hues of purple, jade, and sapphire with velvety matte and shimmer finishes. So I did buy this. I actually ordered it like yesterday. I want to try it out for my channel for you guys. And I actually, where I tried the Morphe palette in that I got in my BoxyCharm, I was kind of excited to see what these are like because it's actually right up my alley on colors because I love purples and greens and pinks. So it's right up my alley on colors. So I thought that I would try this out for you guys. So when I get it in, we'll have to see what I think of it and what we think of it. The Grande Cosmetics, I guess is what it is, has coming out with a Grande Hair Collection. They have a rejuvenation serum, a shampoo that cleanses and exfoliates, a conditioner, and you can get in different kits you can either get the three-piece system, shampoo and conditioner, or a starter set that has a 20 milliliter serum, one full shampoo, and one stimulating scalp massager for $65. The three-piece set is $99, so it's a little expensive. But I actually would like to try this because I have a problem with my hair thinning or falling out. My hair falls out all the time. So I've always had that issue. So I would actually love to try this. It's supposed to help with fallout for fullest, thickest, and healthiest looking hair ever. So even if I just tried the serum, bought the serum, which it's $65, and then didn't get the shampoo and conditioner and just got a cheaper shampoo and conditioner, I think that that might be something that I would probably look into before I got all three pieces. But yeah, that's something that I'm interested in, but probably won't buy right away. That'll probably be something good for the VIB sale as well. Next, we have the cutest collaboration ever. That's what it says on Trend Mood. I'm using Trend Mood anyway to look all this up. It's makeup sponges with SpongeBob characters. This is the Junoco and SpongeBob collaboration. You have $24 for the set. You have a microfiber SpongeBob sponge, microfiber Patrick Star sponge, and a Gary Mini Duo, and a Bikini Bottom Bubbles soap bar. Even though my daughter would love this, I'm probably going to skip over this one. I don't think I need any SpongeBob sponges. Even though that's pretty funny saying it, SpongeBob sponges. All right, the last thing that I wanted to go over is the, it's a Pure Defense collection. I'm going to read you about it. So, Pure Cosmetics has come out with a new Defense Anti-Pollution collection. It includes one eyeshadow palette for $34. 12-piece anti-pollution eyeshadow palette features an innovative mix of shamelessly bold, easy-to-blend shadows that instantly bring drama and attention to any look with matte shimmer and satin finishes. 2. Submerge Overnight Detox Anti-Pollution Moisturizer for $34. Helps reduce the appearance of dry skin, fine lines, and wrinkles. Formulated with hydrating wild pansy extract and breakthrough anti-pollution technology, this skin-quenching moisturizer locks in hydration. The third thing is a Matte Mist Anti-Pollution Mattifying Setting Spray for $24. The fourth thing is a Downtown Detox Detoxifying Black Lemon Mask for $28, rich in bentonite, clay, charcoal and lactic acid. This black lemon infused skincare mask acts as a magnet to draw out blemish causing dirt and excess oil that can possibly cause havoc on your complexion. The fifth thing is On the Point waterproof liquid eyeliner pen for $19. The only thing I would be interested in would be the eyeshadow palette. And it actually looks pretty cute with, it's got the purple in the bottom and neutral with a little bit of pink too. It's not something I'm gonna run out and buy. And I don't know if I will ever buy it, but it definitely piques my interest. I definitely would like to know how it is good for anti-pollution. That interests me. But yeah, I don't think I'll be picking up anything of this right now, but it definitely does interest me. But that's all that I have on my list to go over. There was a few other things that I just definitely wasn't interested in, or one thing that I couldn't even pronounce the name of the company. So there's a lot of things coming out right now, and those are some of the things that kind of caught my eye, some things that I just might pick up later. So I just wanted to go over those things with you, talk a little bit about makeup, and comment down below if there's anything you're looking at, anything you're interested in, anything that I talked about, or if there's anything else that's coming out that you're interested in, because I might be interested in it too. So just let me know down in the comments. And if you like the video, hit the like button, also subscribe. I love for you to become a part of our family, become a part of our little community here on the internet. Also, hit the notification button so you can be notified whenever I upload my wonderful content. Share so more people can see the content, and especially if they like the type of content that I make, beauty and makeup, and I'd greatly appreciate it because it helps me out a whole lot. We're trying to get to the giveaway, so that would help you out a whole lot too. So maybe you can get the giveaway. It's going to be on one of the ColourPop palettes. So share so others can share in the joy of the content. But anyways, I hope you enjoyed the video. I guess that's going to be all for me today. Thanks for watching. Bye, y'all.